a topic which is most now talked about, which is the whole OTT theater discussion, which keeps happening. I mean, I know Sachin, you've just come off a Netflix film.
I'm still making
You're still,
it.
yeah, you're
Yeah.
still in it. You're there
Yeah.
as we speak.
Are you
And
finished shooting?
I finished shooting, yeah, in Kochi. I finished the entire Kerala shoot, and the post-production is going on. Yeah, thankfully we
Really,
finished.
really looking forward.
Yeah.
And that's another adaptation of his own novel. So, I mean, how difficult was that to just touch upon?
Very difficult. I think to adapt your own novel into adapt any novel into a film is a tough thing, because I think the choice has to be very careful. And to adapt your own novel, first of all, into a screenplay and then direct it, I think it's a double it's a two-way challenge, I think. So it has been extremely learning as an experience. But I think what we I mean, we have to face it. Once you decide to do it, then I think I've done efforts, and we'll have to see, because I was extremely reluctant, first of all, to write the screenplay. I really wanted a companion to write, but then there was nobody who could understand the novel. For cinema, I mean, in a cinematic perspective, because also it's a philosophically an autobiographical novel. I didn't want it to, without disclosing too many parts about my life, I just wanted to create a world which I know has happened to me and my life, but I don't have to directly share it with a co-writer. So then I decided to secretly, create the screenplay in itself. It has been an extremely challenging and interesting process. Anjali, have you adapted any novel into a film or any play?
No, I'm trying to,
Okay.
but I
Okay.
haven't sort of done something. No, not yet. Not yet. But
Yeah.
isn't it nice, Sachin, when we really push ourselves to do something that is different? I
Every time,
find
yeah. Yeah.
there's such a tremendous growth
Yeah.
in pushing ourselves to do these
My
things.
only hesitation was revisiting my childhood, which I didn't want to, not childhood, but the age of puberty and this whole adolescence, basically. I think for some people, it's the happiest time in their life, which they always want to revisit in poems and songs and their picture albums. That was the darkest period of my life, my whole period of adolescence was. And Cobalt Blue is exactly about that. And I had to revisit the great part is this Netflix's team, because they just let you be. They just let you nurture the film the way one should. The director needs time to develop the script, and they let you be, first of all,
It's wonderful.
on the film. And that has been otherwise, in a theatrical system, this film wouldn't have been possible. It's happening because there's a strong OTT platform supporting it.
That's excellent.
So I don't I think we are in great times as filmmakers with them.
But does the narrative change? I mean, does the writing screenplay-wise change directorially, shot-taking-wise? I
Yeah,
mean,
you have read the novel. It happens in Pune, and the film is in Fort Kochi. See
yeah,
where you want to go and spend your life, you place your films there. Then you go there for recce, then you go there for shoot, then you go there for, yeah.
I'm just saying in terms of big screen versus OTT, you know, I mean.
You know, Anjali, on the first day of my shoot, we were doing a test shoot, and my DOP, who's an Italian DOP, Vincenzo, came and asked me very politely, and he asked me privately, Sachin, are we making it for, I mean, this shot that you told me right now, this lens, what do you have in mind, a mobile phone or a theater screen? And you know, that was devastating, because in my life, I have never, we don't come from that. Now, I think this next generation of directors, I never thought that this shot will be watched on a mobile phone also. I said, what, Vincenzo? I have never thought about it. I want to do my lensing, and I want to take my shots. So that was a scary moment. He asked
You
me, are you
know,
watching it on a mobile? Are you looking this film on an iPad? I said, I don't, Vincenzo. I'm looking it in my mind, and that dark, beautiful theater I have a big screen in my mind. Yeah, what else? I mean,
no, this is a very pertinent question, and
yeah,
I can't stop asking myself that.
Yeah,
yeah, because when you're crafting your shot, how it will be seen, what is the, you know, how your pauses have to be, how even performances, everything,
yeah,
frankly, you know, what it's, I remember when I made my first film, there was a certain actor who was you know, doing it in a very underplayed way. And I kept wondering, am I not directing it well enough? Is it too underplayed? And then I remember watching this in the dubbing, and wow, I realized this is exactly how it should be done. He should not give me more than this.
Yeah.
That comes from his experience. But that difference is there when you're watching this on a mobile phone.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think it does affect craft.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, some people may be more sensitive to it than others. I don't know. But when I have actually spoken to OTT people itself about it, they don't seem to see it like that. But I think one should look at it, because it will affect the way we make our films.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, especially, you know, content which is emotional content. Mm. You know, if it's action films and things, it's a different thing. But when you're talking about pauses, when you're talking about eyes, when you're talking about, you know, nonverbal communication, then it does matter the size of the screen.
Yeah, it does matter.
It really does.
Yeah, yeah. It really does.
No, I think not only screen. So what the word is, since the last 1.5-2 years, I've also, you know, generally been on set working, and, you know, you hear other actors around you talking, you hear filmmakers which are working on the OTT platforms that you're working with. And everybody seems to have an opinion that, oh, now only the Bahubalis and the Avengers and you know, the big extravaganzas, the Suryavanshis and Simba and Singham, that is going to be, or Tenet, or, you know, those kind of films. But the smaller ones are going to be or should be viewed privately. And I tend to disagree, because I day before yesterday, I saw this beautiful film called Sound of Metal. You know, and it's a very character-driven film. And it's a, if you've not watched it, it's a film about a drummer who loses his hearing. And so sound design plays such an important part. Yeah. And I remember pausing the film and actually, you know, kind of trying to soundproof my house, and I was getting anxiety because I was like, if I was in an actor in this film, I would have been so anxious about, because the sound design is it's like how the van is a character in Pude and in Happy Journey. The sound design was a part of that narrative, of that character. You as an audience are hearing how he's you know, he's hearing muffled, he's hearing extreme sounds at times. And so what is your take on this whole, oh, only the big ones are going to be there, and then the, you know, is that a fair analogy to make?
I've never been an expert. I'm a storyteller. So also, I think what this time has taught us is that we can't predict anything.
Yeah.
We must live in the present tense and humbly keep working on the work that we are doing. So I think it's not about us to discuss this.
I think Sachin put it very well. You see a lot of people who are experts on a lot of things sitting on many panels discussing the present scenario, when actually I don't think many of us know much. We have no idea where it's going.
Where will it go? And
we really don't know.
Our job is to create stories, to live with that experience of creating. That's our job.
But I will say, I'm you know, I'm really worried as an audience member, because I want to go back to the theater and watch the movies.
Yeah, same.
And, you know, I don't want to miss out on all those little sounds that you're talking about. And when we're in post, you know, the attention we give to all those tiny details.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sitting there hoping somebody will catch it. Similarly, all the films you're watching, you know, the makers will be putting those things in there for us to catch. And to watch it on you know, a television screen or a computer screen is... somehow
I understand
less of an
experience. I understand
but at least as a suicide, I think it reaches a lot more people.
No, but the other side of it, I will say, is that it really opens up avenues for a lot of different kinds of cinema. And that's like what Sachin is saying. It is not just about, you know, the kind of cinema, but also the process of making it. That, like he's saying, that Netflix is enabling him to make it in a certain kind of way. That is lovely. That is really lovely. And that way, I think we'll also end up a little spoiled. Because, you know, we're liking that. And I think we would be more demanding of producers to be able to create that kind of an environment for us to work in. A more director-friendly environment.
And also cross-pollination of the audiences. You know, I mean...
Absolutely. I mean, I, you know, why would I be a fan of Kombalangi Nights otherwise if OTT was not there? I don't travel to Kerala every month to watch films. But... Super Deluxe in Tamil Nadu, for example, such films. Why are me and Anjali admiring each other's work, or we have a common base of films which we both admire? Because I think it's because of OTT. In a society like India, where there's so many regional identities, I think OTTs do wonders to each other. That's what I feel. So I think coexistence is a mantra, and I think let everything coexist in a beautifully balanced way. That's what we should aim for. There should not be power dynamics of mediums, of producers, of there should not be powers which stop somebody just because that someone is small, that someone is new, and that someone is extremely original from working. I think that's the most healthy environment for us as filmmakers.
You're totally right. And also that, you know, when is a film a big film or a small film? I think this kind of an environment takes that away. Right now, what is talking is content. You know, and you may be a known actor, a superstar, you know, a known writer, a total newbie. At the end of the day, if the person is sitting and watching on screen, it's because your content is great. You know, and that is such a leveler. Such a fantastic leveler. No longer is it about how much budget you had, or which region you're from, or who is distributing your film, or who is producing, or sometimes not even who's acting. You know, these things have actually come down to a more realistic level. And it's the stories which are surviving. And that is so wonderful. I think that is something that the OTTs have given us. So maybe even when we go back to the theatres at some stage, I'm still hopeful. You know, we may still want that great content. You know, which I think is great for the audiences, for us. As I'm speaking more as an audience member. I mean, I'm so excited to be able to watch all this at the same time. I feel like a kid in a candy store. And, you know, every night I can watch a really special film. This is so brilliant. And I don't have to wait for, you know, that once a week screening on Doordarshan, which used to come, or, you know, somebody else choosing the films or anything. This is, you know, this is there for us. And we're all so excited when Chaitanya Tamanne's Disciple comes out. You know, we're all so excited when Georgie comes out. Isn't that a wonderful thing to share? That across languages, we're excited to see each other's films. And waiting for Cobalt Blue to come out. It's It's such lovely solidarity that is building up. And because of that, I'm so sure people across industries will start to work together. And, you know, that's going to be a really enriching space.
I mean, see, it's the way she's speaking right now. I came to Kerala, I shot a film there. I could work with Purnima in the film. I mean, look, it's a Marathi novel, a Hindi film, and a Malayalam actress doing such wonderful job in it. I mean, this is what India is about, and I think this is happening right now. So,